Hello, and welcome to The Works. I'm Ben Che.
And I'm Ben Peltier. From the 22nd of July, the Strings Department of the School of Music of the Hong Kong Academy for Performing Arts will present a seven-day festival of music for the cello. In part two of the show, eight students from the Academy will be here to tell us more.
In Chinese opera, face painting is a symbolic language. Colors and shapes can reveal a character's personality, social status, and moral code. However, in Sichuan opera, the colored facial patterns are not painted. Bian lian, or face changing, using masks, is an important element of the art. The technique was introduced 300 years ago in the Qing dynasty, and you can still see it in Hong Kong. While the facial color schemes and the symbolic meanings are similar to those of other forms of Chinese opera, such as Beijing opera, one of the highlights of Sichuan opera is the bian lian, or face changing. With a snap of a finger, the mood of the character can change.
《白蛇传》入边嘅嗰个变脸嘅演员咧，其实佢系饰演咗一个精灵嚟嘅。咁佢要同白蛇去打斗嘅。佢点解要加呢一个变脸嘅绝技去点缀佢咧？就系要表达呢一个精灵啊内心世界。咁我哋委派变脸啦，系加咗一啲嘅西式面谱，就音乐都变埋一啲嘅流行曲。源自于咧我爸爸嘅，我睇佢表演咧。 佢係一個轉身，突然之間轉咗音樂，係一個Only You嗰個音樂。一個轉身，然後飛吻就已經變咗另一個面譜。傳統嘅藝術之餘，亦都希望觀眾係睇完呢個表演之後，係一個快樂嘅回憶帶翻屋企嘅。
Hathor Y was born into an acting family. In his 30s, her father Y Shui Kwan was a full-time Beijing opera performer. At 45, he went to Sichuan to learn the face-changing techniques. In 1993, he was the first person to bring the art to Hong Kong. His success encouraged Hathor to follow in his footsteps.
Because at that time, I was in the first stage of the Hong Kong opera. I was in the first stage.
佢喺度一定叫我幫佢化妝，
我好想去觸及，即係想到係幻想自己會喺個台上面打關鬥啊咁樣。咁但係就佢唔俾我去接觸啦，佢覺得女仔唔應該做呢啲啊，好辛苦啊咁樣。呢個小小嘅心願咧，一路就埋藏喺個心入邊。咁到長大嘅時候，係突然之間有一年咧，不如你去上海學京劇先啦咁樣。
咁我年紀越嚟越大啦，咁啊應該點咧？我諗係唔得，應該交俾阿女。
以前咧就係全男不全女，我自己諗，我要突破，傳俾個女先，因為全世界係冇嘅，係得一個，第一個傳俾個女，學邊面冇基礎係唔得嘅，所以諗最好去呢個京劇院、京劇學校去學咗基本功先。2003年大概3月度咧，就去咗上海嗰度嘅戲曲學校就學京劇啦，咁好似一關一關又過到咁樣。 然後到你叫我學變臉啊，咁咪想挑戰一下咁樣。咦，又好似OK咯喎，咁咪一步一步繼續沉迷落去咯。我天賦係一日嘅時間要學識變臉啦。咁但係之後其實我都係需要去整合自己嘅舞台風格啊、服裝啊、音樂啊、成個編排流程啊、表演嘅流程咁樣。其實成嚿嘢由零去到出到嚟都係要用咗一年嘅時間嘅。
對呢個變臉咧，我有四個字。 神奇妙美，点样变得好？点样变得靓？人哋觉得睇哇，真系好正喎！用呢四个字咧去要求我自己，亦都将呢四个字嘅要求咧传俾咗阿女阿仔。The
Y family has given the art of face changing an international profile.
俾你嘅，以后你要接受佢，
唔系啩？挑战。<laughs>
In 2010, Wai Shui Kwan became a Guinness World Record holder by changing 72 masks in 5 minutes. He is also proud of his daughter's achievement in 2019 when she won a gold medal in the US World Championships of Performing Arts.
老豆是健力士，你又金牌銀牌，哇好多獎喎，犀利過我喎！唔係，
力士我都攞唔到啦，你一個頂我10個啦。<laughs> 因為美國 嘅呢一個比賽咧，佢係從來都未有過變臉呢樣嘢出現。我嘅膊頭係好重嘅，背負住呢一個藝術啦、中華文化呢個名啦、我哋自己嘅招牌啦咁樣。整個參賽的賽區其實有30个国家，1000多定2000多个选手，一級一級上去才可以去到他們那晚一個全美直播，就在一個大舞台那裡去表演的，拿了3个金牌，其中一個金牌就是那個 Variety Show 的全球總金獎。他是我的真的透過變臉第一塊的金牌，除了拿個名譽回來，對於自己來說我覺得都是一個提醒和一個進步咯。
20 years of face-changing performance in over 30 countries has enriched Hathor's life. She is now married to Ivan Ma, who is also a stage performer. In 2006, they set up a company to promote the art of face-changing in Hong Kong. One of their goals is to bring it to schools.
場實在的有質感的表演咧，真係能夠拉近咗佢哋對變臉的感覺認知。哇！我覺得是需要手把手去傳承的一樣嘢。
好啦，預備。
揮嗰件披肩嘅角度啦、力度啦，點樣去帶俾觀眾一個震撼嘅感覺啊、速度嘅感覺啊？當分享嘅時候咧，就更加真實地去話俾同學仔聽：，喂，原來我哋變臉唔係你所諗嘅，求其揮一個譜嘅，我哋每一個動作都係有意思嘅。
究竟有幾多人真係願意擺落？傳統的東西我覺得是少的，這個土壤是難的，真的要他入門去做應該試一下，年輕人沒什麼誰會捱得住那個持久性，覺得是不是真的可以適合他們做呢？我們都很想會找到一個適合的人去傳承這件事。如果你說我自己的小朋友呢，我會想讓他們去接觸了先，是的，我又沒得逼的。20年都是一個關口，打後的日子呢，如果我身體許可的情況，都會想繼續做下去的。作為一個演員，我的出發點由頭到尾都是我希望我的表演是會帶給觀眾一個快樂的回憶，大家是開心的，對這個文化是尊重和欣賞的，我覺得都暫時來講都足夠。
Before Kai Tak Airport closed in 1998, visitors and residents alike were often struck by how low the planes were flying over the rooftops of Kowloon City.
A quarter of a century has passed since its closure, and the airport's history is now the focus of an exhibition by photographers Greg Girard and Birdy Chu at Blue Lotus Gallery. Goodbye, Kai Tak, and thank you. Welcome back. From the 22nd of July, the Hong Kong Academy for Performing Arts will showcase the cello repertoire in the week-long Academy Cello Festival. It is, says the Academy, a student-led festival. Students from the strings department will perform in a series of concerts alongside alumni and faculty members. And some of them are here to tell us more.
Well, I'm here with a couple of students from the Hong Kong Academy for Performing Arts, Charlotte and Trevor. Thanks so much for coming in. It's great to have you guys here to talk to us about this cello festival that the Academy is running. The curious thing about this is that I've noticed in the literature about the festival, it's mentioned as a student-led festival. So perhaps can you share with me a little bit about what that means?
Student-led means by our senior students who decide to create this festival. Let's say the other departments, the teacher will lead the students and participate more in the preparation work. But for our festival, our teacher led us to prepare everything and just stand behind us and give us support.
There's another thing is that I want to just talk about a bit more about student-led, is that I think the main difference is student-led is not getting paid. But since we're not getting paid, we have much more artistic freedom to do what we really want.
So let's talk a little bit more in the details of what this festival entails, the different sorts of projects and concerts, and if people are interested in finding out more about the cello, you know, what are some of the concerts and events they can come to hear you guys play?
This year is the second year of our cello festival, and same as last year, we have opening concerts, junior showcase, ensemble concerts, and gala closing concert, and as well two senior students recitals. But this year, we are adding one concerto night, so we are going to play two famous repertoire, Tchaikovsky Rococo Variation and Haydn in D major. So. This time, we're not accompanying by the orchestra, and we're accompanied by a cello ensemble.
This is quite remarkable to me, this idea. It's being backed up by other cellists, right? So that kind of, in a way, speaks to the versatility of the instrument of the cello, right? With a wide range.
Right. That
you can play violin parts,
exactly.
For example. What's that experience been like?
It's been really challenging, because, as you know, violins, they have shorter strings and they have way higher range. We can reach that with the cello, but it's going to be way more technically more difficult. We have to really play our hearts out and play a more full sound if we get more technical. And of course, we have almost less instruments, like instrument parts, than the orchestra. So we have to do some adjustments in the arrangements, and we usually find our scores, you know, on the web. But when we find something that's not quite right, we can add them ourselves.
I understand from reading about you, Trevor, in fact, that you weren't always as passionate about the cello as you are now. That when, at the beginning, for example, it felt that practicing maybe was a little bit more of a chore and that sort of thing. But that sort of mindset evolved over time. That's, of course, different than how you feel now. So I'd like to understand this evolution.
Actually, I'm still figuring out when I started to like the cello, actually. So when you study primary school in Hong Kong, you're basically forced to study a sort of art form and a sport. My mother asked a friend, and he said, he's quite large in size, so maybe he's fit for the cello. That was the decision to play the cello. And, you know, as like any Hong Kong students, you're forced to do everything. But maybe, I think the story right now, as I've remembered, is maybe when I was in secondary four, I went to a trip to Austria to have a master class with the locals and teachers from the Mozarteum University. What really changed me is looking at people from all over the world doing the same thing as me. And I realized that it's more important than I think, like practicing this every day. It really became my passion after that trip.
Charlotte, turning to you, I'd like to understand maybe a little bit about your perspective on coming to the cello as a younger student, and then the evolution to the point where you are now.
My story is basically same as Trevor. I didn't choose cello for myself in primary school. My mom chose it for me. I didn't like it until I get into APA. Since looking at my classmates, my fellows, they really enjoy playing their instruments. And I start to explore different repertoires and reading other cellists' stories. And I start to like playing cello last year, I think.
Well, it's a good thing that we have you both here to play some cello, and I understand you'll be joined by a few of your colleagues as well here on our stage to play us a bit of music. What would you like to do?
Actually, we'll be playing a medley on Tchaikovsky, the Nutcracker Ballet. And we would like to dedicate this piece to the teachers, Professor Wang, and all of the faculties and the people behind this project. Hope you enjoy it.
Great. I'm looking forward to it.